7:50. A new series of Dragon's Den started last night with budding entrepreneurs looking for cash and help from those millionaires.
Like many, Paul Ward left the den empty-handed when he was on the show 2 years ago, but it was his own choice. He rejected an offer to go it alone.
Well, Paul is on the sofa now, along with his brother Andrew, who works for him. Any pressure employing the brother in this one?
Yeah. I've got a lot to put up with.
You've still got to prove yourself, though, I'm sure. So tell us a story, then, quickly. What happened, what the invention or the product was, and what happened during the show?
Well, the product is a product which kills hospital superbugs, bacteria, odours. So I wanted a product which was great for sports with the Olympics coming up. But more importantly, it killed swine flu, norovirus, that type of thing in the laundry.
So you'd had this idea, you went to school in the evening, didn't you, and tried to learn about chemistry. I mean, brilliant sort of get up and go for doing that. You had this idea, it was doing quite well, and you wanted the money. I think we've got a clip for when you went on to the den, and we can see the reaction you got at the time. Let's have a look.
It is a good offer. But I just think at this stage in the business, I just can't take that offer. But I'd like to say thanks for making the offer to me. I'm the driving force with this. I've developed this. You know, this is my life for the last couple of years. And for me to give 30% of my, it's just not doable. So I would like
Even though you get it back?
Even though I get it back.
Then I'll declare myself out.
Thanks a lot. Thanks for your
time. My pleasure. Thanks for coming in.
Thanks.
So you wanted to give away 5% and they wanted a bigger chunk. And you were having none of it. What did you make when you saw their reactions? They looked like they couldn't believe it.
Well, they thought it was a loon, so I just said, it's 5%, for £100,000, take it or leave it. So I decided that I wasn't going to give any more than that away and walked out,
What was your reaction when you heard this? I guess, did you hear quite soon after that happened what your brother had done?
Really? What's he done, yeah. I did think, what's he done, but it's such a good product. And I believe in my brother, because it's... I'm the youngest of all the brothers. I mean, it's not just those two, there's another two brothers. But, at first, my first reaction was, what have you done? But, I knew that we've got a good driving for the
Were you going to be part of it irrespective?
No, I come into it a little bit by accident,
right,
to be honest. I was there when he first went on the Dragon's Den, but he wanted to get a website going. So he asked for me help originally, so I was just helping out at the time.
But you've done all right since, haven't you?
Yeah, it's done great. I mean, obviously, we now got into Tesco, which is fantastic. The deal that they were always, that was the carrot that, get a dragon on board, they'll do all that for you. But we've done it ourselves in the end.
Well, here you go. Maybe you can say, I told you so.
That's right.
Because we have James Khan, dragon on the phone. Good to speak to you this morning. Are you listening to this?
I am indeed. I think what an amazing result, Paul. Congratulations. I know when you came into the den... getting into retail was clearly where you wanted to be, and that was really your kind of passion and motivation. And I think to watch you on television this morning, announcing your Tesco's deal, I understand you're in 500 stores. Yeah. I think it's amazing. And as I said to you before, Paul, that offer's still on the table.
All right, what percentage are you asking for now, James?
You know what? I'm very happy, Paul, to negotiate, because with that offer... You can name your price now this morning, Paul.
5%.
It's a really bad line, Paul.
There you go. He's always a tough negotiator. But most of the people, it has to be said, James, isn't it, who do walk out on people like you, don't do that well. He's the exception, isn't he?
He really is. And I think, it's really tough because when you're in the den, I think for an investor like me, you get 20 minutes to make a decision as to whether you're going to part with £100,000. And obviously at that time, Paul's product wasn't in the market. He hadn't got it established. There was really not materially any revenue there. And it is a really big gamble. And I think it's really difficult to kind of know at that time, will this thing work? I think even Paul's brother is probably sitting there thinking, what have you done? Because it's tough for both sides. I think it's tough for us. I think it's tough for Paul because his valuation was absolutely ridiculous. Even if I say so myself, Paul.
Well, not as
you
were
off. If
don't spend
you were off from planet somewhere. Today, we can look back and say he was absolutely right.
Yeah. Bang on.
Good for you. Sure. And it's great for us viewers to see
these guys get
run over on you guys occasionally. Nice to speak to you.
Are you making loads of money?
Well, we're enjoying ourselves now, right. Especially with my Mrs. Joanne, like, you know. I heard you out, like, you know. But, yeah, I mean, she's put up with a lot, right. Like, you know.
Okay,
yeah,
good. Yeah. Well, what a happy story. Thanks so much indeed.
And to be honest, you could do with giving this studio a whip round. I'm sure there's a few super bugs in here before you leave. Thanks very much indeed.
Thanks a lot.